funny, it's weird even, how we as humans are drawn to a topographical feature like vultures to fresh kill. If it rises from the earth, if it collapses into it, if it rips through it, if it tunnels under, we will clamber over it, we will burrow through it, we will stomp around it, and we'll hang from it. The Grampians here are a classic example. And if the 3-hour drive from Melbourne has got the kids whinging in the back, dangle them from a bit of this and see how long, "Mum, I'm bored," lasts. Sitting in the western part of the state of Victoria, the region takes its name from the Grampians National Park, the area's number one attraction.
How are you feeling?
Terrific.
The heart's, you know, obviously pumping.
We're only several thousand feet up.
It might feel like that. I think it's, metres might sound better. Perhaps about 400 metres above the valley floor.
400 metres?
Yeah, but the abseil's only about 22.
Of sheer drop. Yeah, yeah, you can say yes.
Pretty much. Okay, so, yep, you can keep waddling your way back. Good, so leave your feet where they are. We're gonna rock on over the edge
yep.
now. Okay, so more rope out. Keep going with the rope, a little bit more. And now if you could just step this foot straight underneath here. Okay, and your other foot down the other side. So I can let you go now. I've got you on my purple rope.
Earl, the owner of Hanging Out in the Grampians, has over 2 decades' experience helping guests scale the heights or plunge down them in a completely safe and controlled way. There's no doubt there's a very kind of spiritual feeling going on here in the Grampians. I'm really feeling at the moment, and I'm really hoping that the spirits are looking after me.
As you get closer to the bottom, you'll see a nice flat space for you to land just to your right.
Okay.
Yeah.
This is what a teabag feels like. Wow. All I can feel is my body zinging with adrenaline and exhilaration. A very dry mouth. I'd love to be able to swallow, but my heart is in the way. Oh yeah. If you've dangled your kid off the edge of a Grampian's precipice, taught them a little respect for some admittedly safe and supervised fear, and they're still in your ear banging on about the unfairness of limited screen time, bring them here, still within a galah's screech of the Grampians, for a close encounter with a potential killer. See how they go with that. Just a few kilometres away is Halls Gap Zoo, the largest zoo in regional Victoria. There are over 160 species of native and exotic animals spread throughout the zoo. And if you'd like to get to know them a little better, you can sign up for an animal encounter.
Hi.
They're really ready for interaction, aren't they?
They are.
All ready to get out. They do seem to be just like dogs.
They do seem to, yeah, but they're actually not a dog. Well, your typical dog breed. So these guys are separate canines to dogs.
And this is quite unusual to be this close to them, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. So if you were to see a dingo in the wild, you wouldn't approach them. You're a wild dingo. These guys are very used to people. So they would have been around people since they were born. So that's why we can get so up close and personal.
And they can't be domesticated.
No, so they're not like your domesticated dog. They can get friendly, but they're still a wild dingo. So we can pet them and come right up to them, but end of the day, we wouldn't fully trust them.
God, they're gorgeous, aren't they?
They are.
The zoo spans over 20 hectares, looking out onto the Grampians National Park. There's a range of experiences to be had, but perhaps none more memorable than this.
Wow. So this is a red panda?
A red panda, yes.
Quite a lot smaller than the giant panda.
Very much smaller, yes, and they are not actually related to the giant panda. Can they come down?
Now, the idea is not to touch him, obviously.
Not to pet him, yep. So we're very much, he can touch you, and if you don't put your hand out, you can feed him a little bit of food.
Wow. If ever there was an animal worthy of the word cute, this would be it?
He is ridiculously cute.
Sitting at the base of the magnificent Grampians is the Big Four Holiday Park, an ideal place to base yourself, especially if you have the kids in tow. There's a range of options, but the top of the line is the three-bedroom deluxe cabin, with plenty of space for the whole tribe. It's just a short walk from the town in one direction, or a stroll to the Halls Gap Hotel in the other. This is not your average small-town pub bistro. The meals being served up are nothing short of superb, only matched by the magnificence of the outlook.
You know, there's usually nothing that'll distract me from the total concentration required to fully savour the delights of a Carlton draft. But that view's doing it.